Well, good evening and welcome to Tucker Carlson Tonight. We have exclusive, never-before-seen messages, text messages from inside the FBI. These texts are among the thousands sent between FBI agents Peter Strzok and Lisa Page between February and September of 2016. A lot of them are interesting. Here's a key text. The agents did exactly what you would hope agents would never do. They expressed concern about whether Hillary Clinton, if she was elected president, would take revenge against the FBI for the crime of investigating her. In exchange from February of 2016, Agent Page told Agent Strzok, quote, "One more thing. She might be our next president. The last thing you need, us going in there loaded for bear. You think she's going to remember or care that it was more DOJ than the FBI?" Strzok told Page that he agreed. In other words, political concerns were at top of mind as they investigated this politician, Hillary Clinton. Congressman Trey Gowdy of South Carolina chairs the Oversight Committee in the House. He's a member of the Intelligence Committee, and he joins us to react. Congressman, thanks for coming on. Are we reading too deeply into the exchange we just put on the screen, do you think?
Well, I don't think so, because you read that one in isolation. If you read all the text, it's clear that they did not want her charged. They wanted her to be the president of the United States. They really, really didn't want Donald Trump to be the president of the United States. And they concede throughout these texts that they did things differently in this investigation from any other investigation that they were part of.
So what I don't understand is, even if you're watching this at home and you think, well, I wanted Hillary to win, too, and I don't like Donald Trump, too, shouldn't you be a little concerned, maybe actually terrified, that FBI agents conducting a criminal investigation into a politician were worried about the political elements of the investigation? That's not supposed to happen, is it?
Well, you may remember, as I do, Jim Comey telling us that the FBI doesn't give a whit about politics. He loved to tell us how apolitical the Bureau was. And here we have these texts. Of course, our friends on the left say, well, these are texts between two lovers. Yeah, that's right. You're much more likely to tell the truth when you don't think anybody else is watching. This, I think, is the unvarnished truth of how they viewed both her, him, and the investigation, and how they wanted it to turn out. Keep in mind, Tucker, all of this is done before she was ever interviewed. So the fix was in, unfortunately, before they even interviewed the target of the investigation.
What does it tell you about what they thought of Hillary Clinton? They believed if she became president, she would punish our chief law enforcement agency for investigating her. What does that say about their view of her or their understanding of her?
It's either that, or I think another reasonable construction could be that she would reward the DOJ, thinking it was more DOJ lawyers that concluded she should not be charged as opposed to the FBI. And that's actually how I read it, that she would give more credit to the Department of Justice. You know, keep in mind, reading these texts, it doesn't appear that anyone wanted her charged before they even knew what she was going to say. I read that to be they were concerned DOJ would get the credit for taking care of her more than the Bureau would.
You've taken an enormous amount of abuse, as have your colleagues on the Intelligence Committee, as has this channel, for daring to report this news as if asking questions about the behavior of law enforcement officials is unpatriotic. How do you respond to that?
Tucker, there is no one in Congress that has more respect for law enforcement. I spent 18 years working with them, and it's the best 18 years of my professional life, and always will be. I love law enforcement, which is why these texts break my heart. Bias is insidious. Bias is the one thing in a courtroom, Tucker, the judge will give you the broadest leeway, because it infects and instructs every decision you make when you are biased for or against someone.
Right.
So when I see manifest bias, you know, think back to other important cases in our country's history. I mean, Mark Furman got in trouble not so much for working the crime scene, but because of racial epithets that he had uttered earlier in his career.
That's right.
That's how seriously we take bias. I don't know why the left can't concede in this case that these two agents should never have been part of investigating her case.
Well, you would think that Democrats, at some point, it would occur to them that maybe most FBI agents aren't liberal. They're probably conservative. I'd be willing to bet money on that. So if you allow the FBI to let their agents make decisions on the basis of their political beliefs, maybe that's going to hurt Democrats at some point. Maybe all of us have a real interest in clean and ethical government, but they don't seem to have an interest in that right now. Why?
I don't know. I don't like bias. I don't like political bias manifesting itself in an embezzlement case. I don't like it in a bank robbery case. This was an incredibly politically charged case, as was and is the Russia investigation. So politics and political bias is even more important in a case like this. I don't know why the left is straining to minimize the manifest bias that was exhibited by these agents. I don't get it.
I'm sorry to say this. You got some totally unprincipled people up there with you. I'm sorry about that. Congressman, thank you.
Yes, sir. Thank you.